If you are thinking of building a top-tier, unmatched, extreme, mind-blowing, outstanding, extraordinary website, please stop. It's good on paper, but not on a website. These websites are like fashion show for web developers. They showcase a bunch of over-engineered websites that are impractical and no person would ever want to wear that. You may find this visually appealing because you are very young, but the majority of the internet users are middle-aged or older, and they are not used to seeing slick movements and fast-moving animations. Design is the way of expressing something, not impressing. Of course, it can be used to impress other designers and developers, but your end user wants simplicity. If your goal is to showcase your web development skill, go for creating that complex website. But if your end goal is something different, such as selling a course or creating a blog site, always go for simplicity. The first thing that you should have in mind is that users don't want to learn how to use your website. It should be familiar to them as soon as they show up. Just take the example of the most popular platform, YouTube. They have a fairly simple and intuitive UI, just perfect for a video platform. They have title, thumbnail, and the creator's information. Nothing less, nothing more. But look at similar websites like Udemy. Udemy is a video platform for education, and their UI is quite different. They need to give a sneak peek about their courses with some extra description. If you want to create a website that even a simple 5-year-old can understand, you should mainly focus on 5 different things: colors, typography, spacing, layouts, and making amazing designs. The first 3 are totally in our hand. The 4th one is partially in our hand. The last one requires a lot of iterations. Test, test, test. Every good design you see out there took a lot of attempts until it looks the way it does. Picking colors was something I really suck at, but I used this color wheel to find the complementary colors. If you want to make it further simple, just pick black and white. It's the best complementary color that you can ever have. You will later get used to this after various iterations, or even looking at some designs like this, you can understand that how just simply picking colors changes everything. The second thing that you have to focus is on the typography. There are more than 300,000 fonts, and to pick just one from that, it is really hard. I rarely go beyond the fonts Poppins and Nunito. It is one of the simple and straightforward fonts. Don't use the default font, which is Arial. Just changing the font on your website can give an entirely new look to your website. Keep the typography simple, readable, with high contrast from the background. Next, the important thing is spacing. Start with 1 rem and scale up in 1 rem increments until you find something comfortable, giving elements a room to breathe, especially on large screens. There is no standard fixed value for this. Everything is iteration, and once you get used to it, it will be a piece of cake. Now it comes to the most important part. Start making correct layouts. CSS comes with 2 main layouts, the Flexbox and the Grid. Flexbox can almost do all the work for you. If you want a responsive site, use these 4 lines of code and it works everywhere. Now when you get into a position where Flexbox is not enough for you, start with Grid system. Grid is much more complex, and if you learn it, it can make a huge difference. If something feels off from the rest, scratch it off and start over. It is a composition of elements, and the secret is making them work and look as if they are together. Always try to have a visual hierarchy while building your website. Use the help of fonts, spacing, and everything to make a difference. The highest priority element should have the highest dominance in your layout. Making something look great is all about understanding the rules enough to challenge them. It's knowing when and how to break those rules confidently. That skill will come with practice and experience, which can take years to develop. Some people have that natural knack for it, while others will learn over time. If you can't do this, just steal the code, because good artists borrows and great artists steals. There is nothing wrong in stealing ideas. Your execution is what makes a difference.